Welcome to Microsoft Dynamics CRM 2013 Processes New Features. My name is Ishita Kunwar, and I will be presenting today's session on real-time workflows. In CRM 2013, real-time workflows have been introduced. These real-time workflows can run in the same transaction as the event that they are being triggered for. The workflow infrastructure has also been extended so that it can be invoked real-time as part of a user action synchronously as well as asynchronously. This new feature allows non-technical users like business analysts to be able to easily enforce complex business processes without writing any code. Since this feature reduces dependency on writing synchronous plugins for enforcing all the different business processes, one advantage is also that the effort that goes behind maintaining the code base for a plugin does not need to be applicable to real-time workflows. So any lengthy change processes for updating the code that are typically implemented in different organizations would not slow down how quickly an organization can update their business processes. Let's also run through a quick overview of how processes are managed in CRM 2011 today. So today we only have the option to run background workflows or asynchronous workflows, and the way you could extend this workflow functionality would be via the Visual Studio experience, where you can develop via XAML some custom .NET workflow activities. And also the other experience that is available today is dialogues, which are essentially guided agent scripts. They do support conditional branching and prompting. With the introduction of real-time workflows in CRM 2013, there are some architectural considerations to keep in mind. I will briefly talk about those. So because these workflows are being run by the host, in this particular case, they would be simply executed by the W3WP or the worker process. And if you do have any custom workflow activities that you're trying to execute in a real-time fashion, those would still sit in your sandbox service for CRM Online customers. However, for real-time workflows in general, you would expect there not to be a dependency on the asynchronous service, and instead the worker process would be executing these workflows. Also, these workflows will run in a single transaction. So if there is any errors or issues, the entire operation will be rolled back. This is consistent with how plugins can be developed in CRM 2011 today. Also, simple validation scenarios can now be met with these real-time workflows because we can execute our conditions and our actions in the pre-stage of the pipeline. Specific to real-time workflows, there are some extra steps that are involved to invoke them. So these real-time workflows, after the activation, will be associated to an SDK processing message step, and essentially a plugin would get fired during the main operation then. So each time if you have a real-time workflow that gets activated, that would be registered as a step in your SDK message processing base. And the step would then also get deleted as soon as the workflow gets deactivated by your user. So in CRM 2013, you will see these real-time workflows surface from the main workflow editor, which we will walk through in a quick demo. Also, as we discussed, these real-time workflows are transaction aware and they will fully support pre and post pipeline stages. They will be secure by design, so you now have the option to set context of whether you want to execute the real-time workflow as the calling user or the owner of the specific workflow. This option does not exist for background workflows or asynchronous workflows today. Additionally, a new security privilege is being introduced to be able to activate these real-time workflows. And also, these real-time workflows are fully solution aware, so you can package them and introduce them into your target organizations. So to summarize, with real-time workflows, you can now convert the two different type of workflows in CRM 2013 back and forth. So you will be able to convert a real-time workflow into a background workflow and vice versa. Also, since the pre and post pipeline stages are supported, now you can initiate these workflows before or after an event. There's also going to be a stop workflow action that you can use to specify a status condition of either succeeded or canceled. So this will be available in the workflow editor and we will walk through it. Infinite loop detection is also available on real-time workflows. So what that means is that if there is a situation in which a workflow is executing within a short period of time, more than 8 times, then the infinite loop detection would kick in and prevent any damage to the server resources as well as performance overhead. The workflow failure will also specifically state that the workflow job was canceled due to the fact that the workflow had started an infinite loop. In regards to logging for real-time workflows, this is very limited in CRM 2013. I will walk you through how errors are logged, but at this point of time, there is no information logging that you will see in the system when you're navigating into the website. And the reason for this is, again, because these real-time workflows are being managed synchronously, so they do execute right away, and there isn't a queue that they're pulled out of where we would track them via system jobs. The other caveat with converting real-time workflows to background workflows and vice versa is that wait conditions would not be allowed in real-time workflows. And this is specifically because we want to ensure that the operation can occur in a synchronous fashion right away. Now I'm going to walk you through the real-time workflow editor in CRM 2013. Specifically, I will point out the differences in this editor compared to the background workflows or the asynchronous workflows. I have a real-time workflow called sample workflow open here, and the entity that it is applicable to is account, which you can see towards the right. Notice underneath this there are options to execute this real-time workflow as an on-demand process or as a child process. One additional option which you will see in 2013 is to run this workflow in the background. This is grayed out because the record that we have open here is a real-time workflow. However, if we had an asynchronous or a background workflow open, then you would see this particular option as checkmarked. Towards the right, you're going to see options to retain logs that are specific to any errors that are occurring for this real-time workflow. In most environments, you would want to ensure that this setting is checkmarked. Underneath this, you're going to see some additional options for specifying what the scope of the real-time workflow is and when do you actually want to trigger the particular real-time workflow. Let's go ahead and enable some additional types of triggers. So right now we have record is created type of trigger enabled. I'm also going to checkmark record is deleted. And let's do a third trigger for record fields change. Notice as soon as I did this additional trigger, there is a dropdown on the left which got enabled. Let's click on the dropdown now. You can see that there are two options in here for before and after.
However, the dropdowns that are specific to the record is created trigger and the record is deleted trigger are still grayed out. Let's talk about what these terms before and after mean to the platform. So for those of you that are SDK developers or have some knowledge of the plugin pipeline, basically your before and after keyword refers to the pre and the post stage in the SDK messaging pipeline. Therefore, when you are creating a record, you would want to make sure that you're executing your real-time workflow only after the system has a reference to it, meaning that the record is created. Similarly, when you're deleting a record, you would want to execute your business logic before the record is deleted from the system, which is why these dropdowns are grayed out. However, when you're simply changing the value of a record field, or meaning that you're updating the field, that is an instance where you could go ahead and execute your logic in either the pre-pipeline or the post-event pipeline, which is why we have the option for before and after available to us. So this is terminology that is specific to real-time workflows. There is an option to determine the context of the workflow, meaning which user should execute the business logic. You see that setting exposed here as whether to execute the real-time workflow as the owner of the workflow or the user who made the changes to the record. This is a setting that is specific to real-time workflows and will not be visible in the workflow editor for background workflows or asynchronous workflows. Lastly, there are options to add actions and insert different conditions into the workflow, which you can access from here, similar to your background or asynchronous workflows. One thing that you cannot do in this editor is introduce any wait conditions into your business logic, because this code in the platform for the real-time workflow will always execute synchronously, so it cannot wait for any periods of time. Now I'm going to walk you through a scenario for creating a background workflow in CRM 2013, introducing some business logic for it, and then converting that into a real-time workflow. Let's walk into the process center in the CRM 2013 website, which is available underneath the settings area. So when you access the processes area, you're going to see any workflows that you have in your system. In order to create a new workflow in the system, we need to click on the new button, which is accessible towards the top left. And we're going to specify a name for the process. Let's call this real-time workflow. And we're going to specify a category of workflow. The entity that this workflow is going to be applicable to is one of the custom entities in my system called Project Need. So let's go ahead and locate that in our dropdown. So we have the entity specified now. Notice that there is an option for executing this workflow in the background. I'm going to leave this checkmarked, but if we were to uncheck this will launch you into the real-time workflow editor that I was demonstrating earlier. So now that we've specified the different options to configure the workflow, we're going to click on the OK button. And this will take us to a view of the editor, which would be very similar to CRM 2011. So you'll notice you have the entity, you have the scope, and how to trigger the workflow. There are no options for the SDK messaging pipeline. And the checkmark for executing the workflow in the background is also grayed out. So it is checkmarked, but it is grayed out. So to actually perform the conversion, we're going to have to use the toolbar in this workflow editor.
This concludes our session on real-time workflows.